Chapter 3, The First Night. The next evening, the young shepherds met at the sheep pens on the west side of town, just as the sun was beginning to set. A good number of family members were there to see them off on that first night. They were dressed warmly and for work, with sheepskin leggings, heavy sandals, and thick cloaks thrown over their shoulders. And, of course, each had his new staff. Lemuel's mother was particularly attentive. She fussed around him, tugging and tucking his cloak. She had packed his pouch with more than enough for a meal, and he had some extra bread and cheese tucked into a pocket in his cloak. He was tolerant, but clearly irritated by her attention. The other young man looked on, chuckling. There were several older shepherds there, including a gruff man named Amos, who towered above the rest and had broad shoulders and strong arms. He seemed to be in charge. "Where's Mordecai?" he called out to old Elias, who was hurriedly walking past the pens. "How should I know?" said Elias. "I've been over at Joshua's looking after that new lamb." "I don't keep up with Mordecai. Besides, I gotta get home to Esther. It's getting dark." He disappeared around a corner, still muttering to himself. Amos watched him go, shook his head, and turned to the young shepherds. "I've known you all since you were young boys, except you." He pointed to Simeon, who said nothing. "Your people are from around Tekoa, right?" Simeon lifted his head proudly and nodded. Amos looked him up and down, then grunted his approval. "Tekoa, that's good sheep country. I have family there myself. I bet you know what's what, don't you?" Simeon nodded confidently. "Okay then, now listen up, all of you, and listen good. Tonight we've gathered the flock in that clearing near Jesse's Ridge. That's a dangerous drop-off, so watch yourselves if you have to get near the edge." He glanced briefly at Lemuel, whose face revealed nothing. "Where we gather is decided by the men in the field each day. That's none of your concern. Meet here every night, and you'll find out where to go. There are supply caches near all our spots. You'll find the cache tonight at the base of those big rocks, the ones by that crooked tree. Some of you probably saw it messing around up there when you was kids. Anyway, there's oil and lamps in there, and some primed torches if you have to go looking for anything. I doubt you will. The moon's up, it's bright, and we haven't seen any wolves for weeks now." Hamron looked at Baruch and smiled. His sling was in his hand, and he whipped it around menacingly. Amos continued, "Don't bother looking for the wolves at night. You won't see them. You watch the sheep. Listen for them stirring. Watch for movement on the edges. If the movement gets sharp, whistle and head over there. That's all you need most of the time. Watch each other. Keep the sheep together, and you'll be fine." Mordecai walked up, yawning and scratching. Amos nodded respectfully to him. Mordecai was an older shepherd, just a few years away from going back to the pens. He looked the young men over with a casual glance. "You give them the talk?" Amos nodded. "They're good men. They'll be fine." Mordecai grunted. "We'll see." He turned and faced the young shepherds. "Amos told you what you need to know, but there's one more thing to remember. After I get settled and the sheep calm, I'm going to sleep. Don't wake me unless you have to." Some of the men around the pens chuckled. "If you wake me when you didn't need to, I'll put my staff across your backsides. And if you don't wake me when you should have, I'll crack it over your skulls, understand?" Obed, Noon, and Lemuel looked terrified. All of them nodded mutely. Just as they were about to leave, Amos said, "Hananiah!" Everyone stopped and turned to look at Hananiah. "I'll have that skin," said Amos, holding out his hand and beckoning with his fingers. Hananiah looked guilty and pulled a wineskin out from under his cloak. He tossed it to Amos, who pulled the plug and squirted a stream into his mouth while keeping his eyes squarely on Hananiah. No further words were spoken. The young men and Mordecai moved out into the purple dark of sunset. The journey to Jesse's Ridge took about half an hour and was mostly uphill. They followed Mordecai, who was surprisingly agile for his age. The knotty muscles of his leg showed through the cloth of his robe when he took a step up onto a rock face. He never hurried or strained, but kept an astonishing pace nonetheless. They stepped where he stepped and put their hands where he put his hands. He was silent, so they were as well. Finally, Mordecai slowed down as he stepped off a rock and into a wide meadow that sloped down to a creek bed to the east. The west and north sides were bounded by a deep ravine with a sharp drop-off. They had entered from the south, crossing over rocky crags, boulders, and outcroppings. Jesse's Ridge was well known to all of them. It was one of about 20 places regularly used by the shepherd clans for night grazing. Where they went at night depended on the weather and the time of year. Rotating their location also added extra confusion for thieves and predators. When they arrived, they found a few of the day shepherds waiting for them by the cache. Mordechai exchanged a few words and got the news of the day. Nothing out of the ordinary had happened. The day men looked tired and ready to leave. They walked past the young men, giving them respectful nods but not saying anything. Mordechai motioned for them to gather around, then stopped and squinted hard at Hamran, who had taken out his tinder box and was trying to start a fire. He made a sharp whistling hiss, and Hamran looked up. "What are you doing?" Hamran instantly realized he had made some kind of error and became a little sheepish. "I was starting a fire. Don't we need one?" "Don't start a fire right now. You'll ruin your vision, and we gotta find the edges of the herd first. That's the first thing you do when you get here. Find the edges. Find out where the animals are. They'll be pressed in together because it's dark, but you never know where the edges will be." Mordechai scratched his neck. Then he pinched the end of his nose, digging something out of a nostril with his thumb. He rolled it quickly between his fingers and flicked it away. He cleared his throat loudly and spit. "Watch out for the fire. Understand? You gotta have it, especially when it's cold, but keep it small. And at least one of you stay back from it at all times. If you hear movement, someone's gotta be able to see." All the young men nodded, and Mordechai dispatched them in groups to go out and check the herd boundaries. As it turned out, the herd was bundled nicely into a large group in the center of the meadow. The herd thinned to the east as it stretched over toward the creek. By the time they got back to make their report, Mordechai had made a small fire and was laying out his cloak on the ground, obviously preparing to go to sleep. They stared at him mutely, wondering what to do next. He spoke without looking at them while he was folding the edge of his cloak into a pillow. "Nothing'll come over that ridge. Wolves'll only come over the rocks. They won't cross the creek. No cover for 'em that way. Thieves'll always take the easy way, right through the water. You'll have no trouble hearing 'em, idiots." He punched the pile of cloak that was to be his pillow a few more times until he was satisfied with it. Then he turned for one last look at the young men. They were staring back at him, obviously overwhelmed and disturbed by his mention of wolves and thieves. His face softened, and he smiled. "Don't worry over much about wolves. We haven't seen any in quite a spell, and the last one was a starving, pitiful creature. He ran away fast enough, though, when I put a stone in his backside with my sling." The young shepherds chuckled. Mordechai looked around as if he was telling a secret, and was afraid someone might be listening. "There ain't really any thieves around here anymore, not so much. Oh, I guess anything that might happen does happen now and again, but these days the families know most everyone around, and nobody in their right mind wants to mess with Amos, you know what I'm saying?" With that, whatever gentleness Mordechai had shown melted away. His gruff look returned, and he said one last thing to them before he rolled over and went to sleep. "Remember, watching the sheep is your job, not mine. Do not wake me unless it's an emergency.